Good morning, everybody. So I'm going to get in there. Well, I got about five loads I need to load up over there first thing this morning. I'm going to get the dump truck going and the 330, go ahead and load that up. Going to go down there to the pond site. There's like one more windrow of roots and junk. Load that up, haul that over there to the old borrow pit to spread out and all that. So I get tired of not having rags and everything, so I stocked up on some pig wipers and wipes and everything. I'm gonna put all that in the fuel trailer. Got my fuel cap for the dozer here. Let me grab these. I gotta put all this stuff in the excavator. Each machine's going to get a box of rags from now on. And a couple in the fuel trailer. This other day, actually I need some of those to wipe this off. So the other day, Robert was putting fuel in the dozer, and I don't know if the fuel cap didn't get put back on or didn't get latched good, but the fuel cap is no longer with us. So, I had to clean that off. But Robert being Robert owned up to it and got me a replacement. So that means more than anything. And that's why he gets called first to come help. So when people do little stuff like that, it really means a lot. So let me get that cleaned off a little bit better and this new cap put on here. So don't get dust and dirt in my fuel tank. Nice new fuel cap. All right, that's good to go. Let me go ahead and load out that pile right there. Well, no, I got to put fuel in the excavator here first. I did grease it yesterday, but never got to putting fuel in it. I got to do that and the off-road truck. So give me a few minutes to do that, and we will start moving dirt. Well, my pile here grew. I can't swim this morning. I was thinking it was like five loads, but I didn't actually like climb up here and look at it. It's gonna be a couple more than that. There's a reel of barbed wire. That'll just be dandy. Make sure that gets covered up good. The reason I didn't push this over there, it's like a trash pile, so there's just a hodgepodge of all sorts of crap in it. So that's why I want to spread it out over there in that cut over. That way it can just kind of get lost in the woods there. And then I can cover it up with some other stuff. I might be able to get this in five loads. It's just a lot of stuff here.
dump that.
I shouldn't have second-guessed myself. 5 loads, just like I said. That looks a lot better with that pile cleaned up. I'm gonna go down here to the pond site now, high speed, and load out. There's probably 4 or 5 loads of roots and mess down here. Get all that loaded out, hauled over here. And then I'm gonna come down here and set up the laser, flag out the pond, kind of see exactly where the water line's going to be at, and bring the dozer down here and start stripping.
Out of the bottom, so instead of pushing this behind the pond dam, and you can tell I'm stripping everything off, I need some topsoil up there to finish filling that pit in. So I'm just kind of raking all this up, roots and all, and putting it into the truck and hauling it up there for about 4 more loads. Get all that up there, and I need to cut out maybe about 4 more loads of topsoil for the side of that pad. I'll come down here in the bottom where the dam's going to go and cut that out. And yeah, I'll be ready to lay out the pond then. And I'll probably bring the 7 down here and just start stripping everything and pushing it back here for the back slope of the dam. I'll probably also stockpile, I don't know, 5 or 6 loads of topsoil either over there on the power line easement, or I may put it on that path coming down here, just dump it out and kind of build a little bit of a ridge to drive down. Yeah, I'll figure that out because I gotta be able to load it back into the truck. Might have to use the 220, but I'll figure that out. Not a whole lot of places to really stockpile topsoil and it not be in the way. But I'll take all this fruity stuff up there to cut over and dump it out and not have to deal with trying to flate it off back here anywhere.
I bought this
bigger bucket, you can almost scoop up the majority of stuff. I mean, you've got these sticks in here, everything, but this thing will actually pick it up relatively easy. So let me go dump the load that's on the truck, come back, get a couple loads of this, and probably four loads of, I'm just going to dig out this stuff right here. This is where the kind of rocky and everything, but I need to cut this out anyways and haul it up there for that barn pad for the slope on that to kind of help soften that. That'll be a good spot to get rid of that stuff at. So let me go dump that load and get the rest of this and haul it up there. Let's dig four or five loads out of the head section here now. Got some topsoily stuff. I'm gonna dump it on the edge of that building pad up there on that slope to kind of soften it a little bit. Plus, I need a spot to get rid of some of this stuff. Wasn't planning on hauling it up there, but for four or five loads, it'll be all right. Try to grow some grass to keep from washing. It'll probably be a year or so, a couple years at most before he does the building there. So I want to make sure that hillside doesn't erode too bad. The pad won't go anywhere because it's flat. It ended up being a pretty steep little slope there, which I knew was going to be about 5 feet tall. So that I'm gonna make a good little hill. You can hear the gravel, you hear it? I remember when I was clearing, I ran into that vein of gravelly stuff. You can kind of see the valley in here now. Got a nice valley.
Just got the some topsoil stockpiled over here. Just hauled 6 loads over here. And that's actually some really nice topsoil. What I think I'm gonna do is go up there and get the 7. Come down here, push all this crap back over there and start building that side of the back of the pond dam. And then I think what I'm gonna do is push all that over there as well, and then come in here and just push some of that up the hill and stockpile it along that the edge of that right away there to spread back. I think it'll be a little bit faster. But that's not bad looking dirt there, considering everything's red clay up here. It's got some roots in it, but once I spread that. Well, the old dozer has been worked hard now. It's about, yeah, it's too hot to touch. I should be missing a lot of paint on the blade now. Oh yeah, getting it shined up. So, I've been on that for the last couple of hours. I've taken all this, pushed it down there, pushed a pile up over there, and then I started taking all that and pushing it up into rows. We'll end up having to load that out. By the time I dig the core trench, I'm gonna have so much dirt that I don't need to put anything else on the back of the dam. Trying to keep the dam as narrow as possible to keep the pond as big as possible. So we'll haul that out tomorrow and take it up there and dump it beside that barn pad up there. Hopefully I didn't screw myself by dumping all that topsoil right there and it get all wet. It's a little bit wet, but hopefully the truck should pull up and go through the hill. If not, I'll have to dig it out of the way. But I'm gonna go up here and grab my laser, set it up, grab some flags, and go ahead and flag this pond out. But I think it's pretty much somewhere, you know, everything that I've cut out. So it'll be a nice little pond right here once it's dug. So pond lays in here just like I thought it would. It kind of goes right straight here through to the cab of the excavator, right here, up around, up there towards the stump and the washout, pretty much about 6 feet down from the tree line right there, hugs that, and then about 10 feet down from the tree line right there, and then the dam's gonna tie in there. So I still got a little while to work today. I'm gonna come over here with the 330, start cutting out and shaping that section, head section out right here, stockpiling any dirt right here. I'm trying to get a good 4 feet, you know, down there in that bottom, it's a good 4 feet. And then once it goes down, I think I checked it down there, it's gonna be about 15, 16 feet deep down there. So pretty good depth. And then I'll cut all this clay out right here for the pond. I was pushing it with the dozer, but I think it's just gonna be as fast to throw it in the truck back over there and dump it in there. All right, let's dig a little dirt out up here. All right, finishing up today. Starting to look like a pond here now. I ended up getting the head section cut out. That topsoil piled up. I started cutting some of that mess out right there. Had a lot of rock and stuff in it, so I was taking it up there to the old borrow pit to dump it out. Hauled another 5 loads from there. Probably wasn't a great idea to put topsoil here. I don't know what I was thinking. Clearly I wasn't. I didn't realize I was going to have to haul so much more stuff out, but it is what it is. Might have to scrape some of that up so the truck can get through there a little bit easier. It's a little bit wet. But come back here tomorrow, get all that cut out, or that hauled up there, or that pile hauled up there. I'll probably let Robert load and haul that up there while I take the 330, cut the core trench in all the way around, and hopefully we'll start moving some clay about lunchtime and start getting that dam put in place.